Hi, I'm Jos Overschie, passionate trainer and consultant at Ovedicon. And in this YouTube video, I will tell you more about what makes the perfect impeller selection. We will do that in the following steps. I will show you some impeller types. I will tell you what makes the perfect impeller selection, and I give you some examples. I want to show you some impellers because there are many impeller types available. This one is called a closed impeller. We also have a semi-open impeller and an open impeller. We have a channel impeller and an open channel impeller. And we also have the centrifugal screw impeller. So a lot of different impeller types. But what makes the right selection? Maybe you know about the rotation speed of an impeller, about the capacity of an impeller, the total head of an impeller. But the most important thing by selecting the impeller is the medium properties. So that will be leading, that must be leading. For clean water, it's very easy. Every impeller type I just showed you will do the job. But what is the right impeller for clean water? Then you look at the efficiency of the impeller. Normally, a closed impeller has the highest efficiency because there is a back shroud and a front shroud. So for clean water, select a closed impeller. If we have water with small particles, like stones, like this one, if you try that with a closed impeller, the stone will come in the impeller eye, but as you can see, it will stuck in the impeller. And that really happens, I show you in the next picture. In this picture, you see a closed impeller. The picture is made that we are looking in the impeller eye. You see the vanes of the impeller and you see the channels of the impeller. And one of the impeller channels is blocked. And is blocked not by a stone, it's blocked by a chicken bone. And when one of the channels is blocked, you will get vibration of the impeller because the impeller is unbalanced now. So be aware, just a chicken bone can destroy your impeller. The next example is with medium, with particles the size of a golf ball. If a small particle can't pass the closed impeller, the larger one will never do the job. Even semi-open, the open. For this size of particles, let's show you what it will do with a vortex impeller. A vortex impeller is just turning the water around. The medium will come in to the pump and the medium with the particles just pass the impeller. As you can see, this particle, the size of a golf ball, can pass this impeller. But what will this particle do with a one-channel closed impeller? The medium comes in here, the ball can come in here, and it's even possible to come out again. So this closed one-channel impeller will do the job. Also this screw impeller with this ball will do the job. So it's very important also here that the medium properties are leading. The second thing is that if you have chosen some impellers like a vortex, the one channel open impeller and the centrifugal screw impeller, efficiency is leading. The next example, and maybe you don't believe me, but there are people that are flushing towels and clothing through the toilet. And when the medium with a towel enters your pump, it comes in the impeller. And not every impeller can do the job. A closed impeller won't do the job. And even your channel impeller won't do the job. I also have a two-channel impeller here. And as you can imagine, if this towel is entering the impeller, it gets stuck. So also this two-channel impeller won't do the job. For that type of medium with closing, you have to use a centrifugal screw impeller. This impeller will do the job. To show you what a piece of closing can do to your impeller, please see in the next picture. In this picture, you see a closed impeller. And in the impeller eye, there is a piece of clothing. That piece of clothing is a swimming trouser. And that swimming trouser could come in the impeller, but it wasn't able to come out. So there are two solutions. Or you remove particles the size of a swimming trouser or towels from the medium before the medium comes to the pump, or you have to select another type of impeller. Now I have a surprise for you, and that is, I'm wearing my hard hat, so I'm giving you a pro tip. And you also can find pro tips in our e-learning courses. And this pro tip is about the impeller selection, about the medium. Because sometimes you don't know for sure what the particles will be in your medium. You only know that your impeller is stuck every time. So please take out all that particles and collect them. If you have a bucket full, call your pump supplier and the sales guy or girl can, viewing that particles, he or she can select the right impeller type for you. So now I showed you some impeller types. I gave you some examples so you know that the medium properties are leading. After that, you look at the efficiency of the impeller. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and maybe you have a question, please drop that below in comments. I hope to see you again, and you can also visit our website. See you next time. Bye.